please get ready for transcription number 17, part 2 at 80. 5 seconds. Start. Since they represent the village people and they have the resources and the powers to raise the necessary resources from the rural areas, the panchayats, it is felt, are the competent authorities to deal with the problem of rural industrialization. Equally strongly, it has been argued by others that cooperatives are the right answer to the question as to which should be the authority that should deal with rural industrialization. I may also mention that there is a third school which believes that the import of private capital and private skill into the work of rural industrial development is the real answer to the problem which we face in the matter of rural industrialization. Here again, some authoritative determination of the policy has become necessary, because in the absence of such a policy, ad hoc decisions are taken which sometimes cancel each other, and therefore the rapid progress which we hope and wish for in rural industrialization becomes impossible. Then again, there is the further question of protection that may be necessary for rural industries in view of the lack of the internal economy from which rural industries would suffer. Whatever may be the answer to the first two questions, Professor Malkani has already referred to this question and various suggestions have been put forward. But all these suggestions require some detailed consideration, as there are a large number of difficulties in implementing any one of these suggestions. Demarcation of markets and the imposition of taxes in order to see that goods from the urban centers do not reach the rural centers in unfairly competitive conditions are some of the suggestions that have been made. One great advantage of a vast country is the large number of markets that are available for the goods that are produced in the country. However, if these markets are artificially restricted and goods are not allowed to move from one center to another, I'm afraid more problems would be raised than solved if this protection is sought to be given in this manner. Yet protection has to be given to the rural industries if these rural industries are to develop. Therefore, serious and competent thinking is necessary in this connection, and again time is running fast. Therefore, it is desirable that we should have some authority which could examine the various issues involved and determine the policy with regard to this matter also. Stop.